including this land that we now call Burlington.
Thank you. I can almost certainly assure you that I won't be able to top that with this speech. But it's a pleasure to see all of you here. Thank you all for coming to the final, exciting final concert of yet another fantastic season. My name is Kumar Balan. My colleague Gwen Liu and I are co-chairs of the Oakville Symphony Youth Orchestra Board. Neither Gwen nor I are going to make any statements that will need fact-checking. So if you have your phones out, I request that you put them away. Don't take any pictures. Just enjoy the moment for what it is. Trust me, it'll be a lot better than that. Music, to most of us, symbolizes energy and motivation. Our goal at the Oakville Symphony Youth Orchestra is to ensure that your children own this inspiration long after they stop being part of this great orchestra. As a parent, I can associate with that elation that you feel today when watching your child perform here. Trust me, it only gets better. So I start congratulating all our young musicians for having completed a fabulous season with the Oakville Symphony Youth Orchestra. We're also proud of you. That said, we are discussing the formation of a parent support group for those empty and meaningless Tuesday evenings to tide you over the next few months before coming back in September. As we plan for various activities for the next season, including auditions in the next few weeks, retreats, and possible trips, I would like to acknowledge the enthusiasm of our artistic director and conductor of our symphony and youth band, Colin Clark, conductor of our Sinfonia and Philharmonia, Karen Allen, and general manager, Laura Fitzpatrick, along with various coaches, mentors, ringers, volunteers, with whose assistance we continue to deliver the quality musical experience that you expect of the OSYO. Laura, whom most of you may have met, has officially been with us for a complete season, and she makes this difficult job, seem like a walk in the park that we know it isn't. We're all grateful to you. OSYO is a charitable organization, and we have the good fortune of being involved in activities such as Delta Bingo that bring us revenue. I personally have had the opportunity to volunteer with parents, Bora, Michelle, Chris, I know you're somewhere in the audience, thank you, and a lot of others as well that I'm yet to meet. Thank you for your time and helping us out at Bingo and other events, including at this concert. I would like to take the opportunity to recognize the efforts of our incredibly dedicated team at the OSYO board, and of course their spouses for putting up with the engagement with the orchestra. In no particular order, they are my colleague Gwen Liu here, Mary Clark, Andrew Healy, Mary Catherine Retzman, Faiza Sandhu. Thank you to the Ontario Trillium Foundation, Oakville Arts Council, Delta Bingo again, and our partner orchestra, Oakville Symphony. We appreciate all their support and generosities. But most of all, thank you, dear parents, for giving us the opportunity to mold a part of your child's formative stage in life with something as beautiful as music. I now request our co-chair, Gwen Liu, to share her thoughts.
Thank you, Kumar. Hello, everyone. Welcome, and thank you for being here. I'm really thrilled to announce that we have something truly unique to present this afternoon. You are about to experience the world premiere of a commissioned piece written by a young Hamilton-based composer, Liam Ritz. Liam has been working with Karen and the Philharmonia over the past year to create this piece that we are all eager to hear this afternoon. At the last concert, I had mentioned a strategic planning exercise that the OSYO board and staff were gearing to participate in, and I'm happy to report that we've completed the strategic plan, and it's quite inspirational. Our group identified many focus areas on specifically musician engagement, the creation of leadership opportunities within our different ensembles, increased collaboration with our partner organization, Oakville Symphony, and increased enhancement of our presence in the community. So with the world reopening, we're also really excited to announce that we will be exploring the revival of our travel plans with the orchestra as part of our strategy. This brings me to our final strategic goal that's really important. It's the need for people to execute the plan. in a time-effective way. So at this time, we have at least two board director openings, and we invite you to join us in this exciting journey to make our strategic plan a reality. So if you're interested in participating and being part of this important initiative, please reach out to Laura, Kumar, or myself. It's a really ambitious plan, and we need all the help we can get. Without further ado, welcome again, and enjoy a memorable and enjoyable afternoon. Thank you.
you, and welcome to our final concert of the season. That was Symphony 29 by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, one of his better-known symphonies. Stay tuned for some more Mozart during the Philharmonia set.
Fitting into our movie and TV theme, we'll now play Over the Sea to Sky, which is the beautiful theme song from the TV series Outlander. It was inspired by the poem of the same name by Robert Louis Stevenson. It describes an escape to the Scottish Isle of Skye after failure to recapture the British throne. Listen for the sounds of wind and waves in this lilting melody.
Next up is the two South American tangos. The tango dance form originated in Argentina, composed by the Uruguayan composer. We're playing the second tango called La Comparsita, which means the little parade, in Spanish, and is the most famous tango ever made.
Thank you.
are two iconic John Williams theme songs. The theme from Jurassic Park is also known as Journey to the Island and was filmed in Hawaii, even though it is actually supposed to occur on an island west of Costa Rica called Nubla. The theme from E.T. is actually called Fly, which is heard in the flying scene where E.T. and Elliot take flight for the first time. The pace of the music is established with rhythms in the strings representing the pair taking off. We hope you have enjoyed our set.
Thank you. Thank you. Welcome, audience members. You just heard Game of Thrones, the iconic theme song from the popular TV series. We would now like to play two selections from Mozart's Requiem Mass. These two movements, titled Confutatis and Lacrimosa, which were featured in the famous Academy Award-winning movie Amadeus.
As the Requiem was not finished upon Mozart's death in 1791, Franz Süssmayr, as well as other composers, are rumored to have finished the work. It is also rumored that Mozart did not know who commissioned him to write the Requiem, as well as the fact that he may have believed this was going to be played at his own funeral.
Thank you. Moving backwards slightly through time, we will now move to a non-movie theme, the Vivaldi Double Cello Concerto, composed in G minor, composed in 1720. Although Vivaldi has composed over 27 concertos for the cello, string orchestra, and basso continuo, this is the only concerto composed for two cellos. Our soloists are Eddie Clark and Emily Kim. Emily has started learning the cello when she was in grade 3 and is currently in RCM level 9. She has competed in numerous competitions and festivals and has received many first and second place. And she currently studies with Ashley Choi. Eddie has started playing the cello when he was only 5 years old in the UK. And he has received distinction in RCM grades 1, 3, and 5. And he currently studies with Susan Nakashi. The continuo solo will be played by Elin Ertl. Please give them a warm welcome.
Thank you. Our next piece, Follow, is very exciting as it has been especially commissioned for the Philharmonia Group thanks to a grant from SOCAN. We are fortunate to have the composer here today to introduce his unique creation. Please welcome Liam Ritz.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Liam Ritz, and I've had the immense pleasure of working with the Oakville Symphony Youth Orchestra Philharmonia and Karen Allen, and have written this next piece on the program titled Follow. As a young violinist, I played in youth orchestras just like the ones you're hearing today, and one of the big learnings you have when you take on something like this is how do you play with other people? How are you performing with the musicians around you? And a lot of that is this give and take of learning how to lead and learning how to follow and read the musicians around you. And so I wanted to make that kind of the basis of this piece. Essentially, it's one big game of follow the leader where one section will start a musical idea and other sections will join in at different points, sometimes quite a bit after, sometimes immediately after each other. And so it's this big game that they're all playing together as an orchestra. I'd like to thank Karen Allen, who's been wonderful to work with, these musicians who are incredible, and the SOCAN Foundation for the Arts, who have generously supported this project. Thank you.
Our last piece takes us back to our movie themes. So Gladiator is the epic American film which won numerous Academy Awards, and it's loosely based on historical figures of ancient Rome around 180 AD. And it was released in 2000 starring Russell Crowe and Joaquin Phoenix. The main theme songs in this medley are The Battle, Earth, and Barbarian Horde. Some of you may remember that famous Olympian figure skater Elvis Stoiko won a silver medal while skating to this piece. We hope you've enjoyed our set.
Later, and also a special around this room. Hi. So the Oakville Symphony Youth Orchestra is truly excited to introduce a new award this year, the Jean Grieve Award. Jean Grieve is a well-recognized name in the world of string education in Oakville and the surrounding communities. Jean has been instrumental in giving life to this organization that has evolved to become the OSYO. So to acknowledge and celebrate Jean's contributions, OSYO has established the Jean Grieve Award to recognize the importance of youth and music education and award it to a deserving Sinfonia or Philharmonia musician. This season's award recipient has demonstrated commendable initiative towards learning and developing in their musical journey. Their passion for music and ingrained positivity has created an atmosphere for fellow musicians to be inspired and to hone their talents. The Jean Grieve Award for this season is being awarded to Anjali Ballin. Now, before we go to intermission, I'd like to hand it over to Dan and Caitlin Emery to make a special presentation to Karen.
I think I'm tall enough, I don't need that. So, good afternoon, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here on the one hand, and it's a pleasure to see you all. When I reflected on this afternoon, I think there might be six or seven people who know us, Karen, Colin, Beata, maybe three or four others, but that's it. Karen has been with the orchestra organizations at the time when we were involved, the Halton Youth Symphony, for 17 years. And 16 years ago, my daughter joined, so Colin contacted me recently and said, we want somebody to talk about the early days. And when I watched the performance of these fine musicians and Karen's conducting, the early days are much like these days. Excellent musicianship, excellent conductor, mentor, teacher, friend, guide. That hasn't changed, Karen, and it's wonderful to see it still happening. Now, back in those days, we had not toured with the, what I'll call the Philharmonia. We had two orchestras, the Philharmonia and the Symphony. And in, I think, 2010, when my son was playing with the Philharmonia, Karen found an ad for a youth orchestra festival in California. She brought it to the board. I happened to be president at the time to see if it was feasible. It was. So we hopped on board with that, took 40 musicians and 10 chaperones and whoever else tagged along, and flew to Los Angeles, and we had an absolutely fantastic trip. We played the main stage at the Disney Concert Hall in Los Angeles. And as a parent sitting in the first balcony watching and hearing everything that was going on with the group of young musicians, it was a very, very touching and important moment. Subsequently, we did a recording at a Disney soundstage, so Disney conductor, Disney sound engineers, and so forth, playing snippets of movie soundtracks. So at that time, The Emperor's New Groove and The Lion King and a couple of others. And to this day, and that was 12 or 13 years ago, my son still talks about that trip, I still talk about that trip. So when I heard Gwen mentioning that they're thinking of getting back to touring, I can only say, parents, get involved, get on the organizing committees. Doing you a favor here. I've been in her shoes. Get on the organizing committees, become a chaperone, make the trip, take the trip, your children will remember it forever and you will remember it forever. But anyway, we're here to pay tribute to Karen. And we didn't know her when our children joined the orchestra 16 years ago, so we didn't know what to expect, and only took two or three rehearsals, and especially the first concert, and then we just said, this is somebody special and remarkable to whom we have given our children to guide and to teach and to conduct and to mentor and so forth. Karen, you did a fantastic job then, you do a fantastic job now.
And I'll just quickly add on to all the things that have been said. Karen, you're truly the best kind of leader and the best kind of teacher. I got to play under her direction for 2 years when I was 10 and 11 years old. And I remember those years with incredible fondness. Karen is such a joyous leader. She leads with so much warmth and dedication, but she also holds the young musicians to such a high standard, and what she's able to accomplish with them is truly incredible. And every young musician who gets to work with her is extremely lucky, so thank you so much, Karen.
To 20 more seconds, if I may. In closing, I would like to, on behalf of the hundreds of musicians that you've worked with, and on behalf of the hundreds of parents who have entrusted their musician children into your care, I'd just like to say, keep it up for another 17 years. Oh, to be clear, Karen's not retiring or quitting or being fired or anything, so you know. This was just a tribute. So we would like to say, on behalf of all of us, heartfelt thank you.
This is very unexpected, and I just want to say I couldn't have done it with these guys. They make me look good because they actually sometimes practice. And I just wanted to add that Caitlin still stands out as an incredible leader herself and concertmaster. I think it was for 2 years you did that. And Dan was phenomenal leader and president. And if we do a tour, I agree, you should get on board. So thanks, everybody, for your kind words.
Thank you, everybody. So we're now going to have a 15-minute intermission, and then we'll return for the rest of the performance tonight.
So the OSYO board has been promising Colin a helicopter for a while. I mean, microchip crisis, heated seats, and all those things are delaying it. But his musicians here at the symphony have done one better. This is for you, Colin. OSYO last year instituted an award called the Builders Award in memory of Colin Litton. Some of you may know Colin Litton. He was a longstanding director on the board of the Oakville Symphony before his passing in December 2020. He was instrumental in framing the strategy of Oakville Symphony, including the purpose-driven and thoughtful affiliation with our own Oakville Symphony Youth Orchestra. Colin was known to be an innovator and builder, contributing significantly to the long-term sustainability and growth of both the Oakville Symphony and the Oakville Symphony Youth Orchestra. To recognize Colin's contributions, Oakville Symphony and OSYO established an award to recognize the importance of youth and music. This year's OSYO Builders Award in memory of Colin Litton goes to Jacob Caparicchio. Jacob, through your participation with the symphony, you've proven that you're dependable, reliable, and exceptionally musical. You've demonstrated your passion for music and the ability to work with everyone by exemplifying warmth, kindness, and respect. OSYO recognizes your qualities as those of an accomplished builder. Congratulations and best wishes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.